We are going to create a diamond shape object. Here we are in the architectural template. Let's select modeling, please. Select generic models. Okay, let's add some reference plane so we can refer to the center point of our polygon and the object. Here we're going to go into Edge, use Swift, Sketchpad. Then we're going to create a polygon with 10 sides. Let's make a smaller one. Let's finish it. Here we're going to edit the profile. Go to North Elevation. Or let's go to East. You can see this line. If you go to 3D, you can see that this line is right on the path that we have sketched. So let's go to the East again. Now we're going to create our profile. Select it first here. I want to move to center, but let's select it here first. Select the height. This is the diamond shape. And let's just. Now let's move this line nearest to this line as much as possible. Now we have created the diamond, the shape of the diamond. When we look at it in 3D, it's in diamond shape. Now we can apply the material. Let's finish the model first. Here in masking tool, let's apply pattern. Edit this and duplicate the diamond. Here now let's not place any grids and also having horizontal and vertical. So here we're going to use the system place panel. Click OK. We're going to consistent shader and to the color that has been predefined on the glaze panel. So if you want to change that color, let's go to system curtain system, curtain as a curtain panel, system panel and glaze. Let's click here. Let's select it, click the glass color and change the color to appearance. Using material, let's say it's bronze with the reflectance 100%. Color of the bronze is custom, let's say this bronze color, golden or yellowish or golden. Apply, and in the graphics we're doing the same. Click OK, click OK, and here in the system based, we didn't apply the curtain voice setting, so let's go to curtain system again. Select this, yes, and create system. So now it has applied the materials and the curtain will material into the faces of this diamond shape. We can change again this color to our preferred one. Let's go back and set it as, let's say, blue green. Let's see what happens. Apply, and it has changed into another color. If you want to hide these lines, you can also do that by going into the modify. And here on the line we set invisible lines. Then you have to select the line one by one, double clicking it. it will be hidden in view. Make sure you're in the architectural file, discipline, and you can select this. This will be hidden, so you can hide some of the lines if you want to make it invisible. Basically, that's how you create a diamond shape object in Revit. Let's change the color back to different color. It's too light, so let's paint it blue. Light blue. So it's much nicer. The reflectance color is much more darker. So that is how to create a diamond object in Revit. Here we can try again the invisible line, so you can easily see it, how it disappears. If you go back to shader, you can see the difference. It's taking out some of the line, but the edges is still there, but the darker lines has been removed. You see this one has the lines, so we have to remove it. So slowly it's removing all these lines. That is how to make it much more nicer without the edges and hidden. Thank you.